Welcome to all, myself Professor Deshmukh MS presenting the theory lectures based on natural frequency of pre longitudinal vibrations. Before going to start any particular things, what is the basic concept of natural frequency, pre vibration, longitudinal vibration that we have to see? Before that is the frequency is the number of oscillations per unit time, that is called the frequency. What about natural frequency? The frequency of the free vibration is known as natural frequency. What is the free vibration? The free vibration is nothing but the what? The vibration which occurs without any external force, only the initial displacement, that is called the free vibration. The longitudinal vibration, the vibrations along the axis of your shaft or along the length of the body, the vibration is called the longitudinal vibrations. So this is the basic concept of the longitudinal vibrations. Now this is the natural frequency of free longitudinal vibrations by the equilibrium method. What we have seen in this case, you have to see in the what kind of the forces are acting on it and how to find out the natural frequency of the free longitudinal vibrations. Now the figure showing that spring mass system which consists of the parameter that is known as what? The mass, weight of body, okay, stiffness of the spring, delta, the static deflection due to the weight W. Spring is attached to the mass M or body which having the mass M. Under the unstrained positions, we are having the two extreme positions, that is X and X, and that of the mass having at the equilibrium conditions, they are having the two forces are acting, that is W weight and that of their inertia force. Okay. Again, at the deflect conditions, we are having the again one more two forces, that is the spring force and that of your the external force, inertia force. So spring force due to the x reflection, that is k in bracket delta plus x. So applying the Newton's second law, that is the external force and the inertia force, our algebraic sum is zero. So restoring force in this case, that is F is equal to minus K dot X. The Newton's law of motion, that is F is equal to ma. So F is equal to minus K into X. Okay. And F is equal to, that is M into area dot none out area, that is acceleration d2x into dt square. Okay, that's the case. Now differential equation of the motions of the body having the mass M is actuated upon by restoring K per unit displacement from the equilibrium position is d2x upon dt square plus K into X, that is equal to 0. For SHM motion, d2x upon dt square plus omega square x upon omega square x, that is equal to 0. So the natural period of the vibration is quite easier one. That is 2 pi upon omega. Omega is just already found out. Omega is equal to under root of m by k. Okay. That k by m. So taking the reciprocal of that, finally we got the t is equal to, that is a natural period of vibration. T is equal to 2 pi under root of m upon k. The actual frequency of vibration f is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root of k by m cycles per second. The spring is strained by an amount delta is due to the weight W is equal to mg. So delta K is equal to mg that we have got. Hence, by equating these two equations, what we have got? K by m is equal to g upon delta. So natural frequency fn is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root of g upon delta. So this is all about the equilibrium method. What about the energy method? The what energy method is says that the total energy is being constant throughout the case. This is based on laws conservation of energy, that is total energy at any instant is constant, whether it is converted from one energy to another energy. So kinetic energy is maximum when potential energy is minimum, and that of potential energy is maximum and kinetic energy is minimum because of total energy is being constant. If one energy is maximum, automatically second energy will minimum. So kinetic energy plus potential energy, that is equal to constant laws of conservation of energy. So by taking the derivative of this constant, it's always zero. Okay, so we have kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 mv² v, that is velocity, dx upon dt whole bracket square. Okay, now potential energy due to the deflection equal to strain energy in the spring, so minus the potential energy change in the elevation of the motion. So potential energy is equal to 0 to infinity 0 to x total spring force dx minus mg dx. So integration 0 to x mg plus kx minus mg dx, that is equal to 1/2 k into x square. So d2x upon dt square plus kx, that is equal to 0 dx upon dt, but velocity dx upon dt can be 0 for all the values of time. So m d2x upon dt square plus kx, that is equal to 0. So finally we got that d2x upon dt square plus kx upon m by the equation of SHM. Now this is the time period, that is t is equal to 2 pi root of k by m, that is m by k. Natural frequency fn is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root of k by m cycles per second. Now there is again one more method, that is Rayleigh method. What Rayleigh method is that? At the extreme point, the potential energy maximum, that the kinetic energy is negligible. While kinetic energy is maximum, potential energy is negligible, that is equal to 0. That the case is given. Similarly, when mass is reached at the maximum deflection, displacement, the potential energy is maximum and kinetic energy is 0. But due to the conservation of energy, total energy remains constant. So assuming that the motion by the vibrations to be simple harmonic, and that of your the case x is equal to a sin omega t, okay, and x is displacement of body from this main positions after time t. So v max is equal to x upon dt max, that is x max omega a. Maximum kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 m² a². Maximum potential energy is equal to 1/2 k into x max square. So maximum potential energy is equal to 1/2 k into a² That is kinetic energy max is equal to potential energy max, m omega square is equal to k. So fn is equal to 1/2 pi under root of k by m. So k upon m is equal to g upon delta. So this is all about your things, that is known for the formulations, how to be got the potential energy, kinetic energy. Okay, means what, you have to find out the natural frequency from this energy conservation of momentum. Okay.